back inside the South Okanagan Event Center as the Edmonton Oilers rookies lead the Winnipeg Jets rookies after 40 minutes of play by a score of 2-0. VP of Player Development for the Oilers, Scott Housen, joins us now. Scott, through five periods of action at this Young Stars Classic, what have you seen from your squad?
Well, it's been a competitive environment. It always is. It's a little bit chaotic because there's not a lot of structure. But I've been really pleased with really throughout the lineup. I thought the strength of the team coming in was defense. Our defense has held up well. The goaltending's been very good, yep, both nights. And we're getting, you know, some production from sort of all up and down the lineup. Obviously, Butcher's been very good for us, too.
I was going to bring up Chad Butcher because he scored his third goal of the tournament tonight. Is there anyone else that's caught your eye and really surprised you thus far?
Well, I've liked William Lagesson. He's been really steady on defense. He's played both games. I thought our defense, again, last night was very good. And, I mean, you can't say enough about what Stuart Skinner's doing tonight. He's made a few acrobatic saves. But
that one in the first period was sensational.
Yeah, but beyond that, his positioning has been good, his compete's been good, and he's given us a really solid outing so far.
When it comes to the staff, especially on the development side for you guys, this tournament, what kind of tool is it for you in assessing the talent that this organization is bringing in?
Well, it can be a little bit deceiving. You know, this tournament is, there's not a lot of structure. It's the first time. So you're really looking at the body of work, and this gives you a good indication about who's prepared well over the summer and who really wants to make a statement here. So those are all positive things that you look for. But again, we're going to watch these kids, you know, for 2, 3, 4 years, some of them, before they become an Oilers, and that's really more important.
A guy like Joseph Gambardella, who played center yesterday, he's on the wing today. What are the intangibles, that he brings to the table as the oldest guy at this tournament and a guy that went through all his years in college, got a cup of coffee in the AHL last year? What do you see in a guy like that? What could he kind of pursue as a path in this organization?
Well, leadership for one. He's always been a guy that's always had to work for everything he's got. He's an underrated guy, comes into UMass Lowell, slowly works his way up, and becomes, you know, a top 10 scorer in the nation last year. His compete level's off the charts. He's never going to leave anything on the ice, and that's an example that you hope the younger guys can follow, and they can see what a good pro is.
For yourself, you've worn many hats in this organization, almost two decades with the Oilers organization. This new role, what's it like for you, and how do you kind of explain it to people? Because we've seen you, you know, in the assistant GM role, we've seen you in scouting, but this one, what does it really include?
Well, first of all, it's an exciting time to be part of the Oilers again. But this role, I'm excited about it. Will be really focusing on the prospects that are not playing within the system. So we're going to have three or four players in Europe, Lagesson or Nima Lane and Philip Berglund there. We're going to have eight or nine in college, and then four or five in junior too. So I'll be following those guys. I'll develop relationships with those players. I'll be giving them feedback on a weekly basis, and trying to get them prepared to help with the Oilers. As our team matures at the NHL level, we're going to need some younger players to come in and fill roles, and hopefully we have some of them here this weekend.
How does the dynamic work between yourself, Peter Chiarelli, Craig McTavish, and you can't forget there's another guy that was a former GM, Kevin Lowe, within the organization? What's it like to have the strength of guys that have had GM experience in the NHL, and how will you work amongst that group?
Well, it's very fluid. I'll report directly to Craig, and you know, we'll have conference calls and meetings where we update the group on the prospects. But it's, you can never have enough experience on the management side, and I think we're well set up here.
Scott, I have to ask you one more. Brian Munns and Gene Principe put me up to this one. True or false, you're a member of the Canadian Ball Hockey Hall of Fame?
That's true.
Really? There we go. We've got confirmation from Scott Housen. Scott, thank you so much for doing this. Always a pleasure to chat with you.
Thanks, Tom.
Scott Housen, the VP of Player Development for the Edmonton Oilers. We take a look now at the Jets mic'd up with Mark Scheifele.